Hello everyone, this is Ankur Budhiraja, Assistant Professor at the BBA Department of GIMS, Greater Noida. In this lecture of Production and Operations Management, BBA 303 paper, I shall be taking up the topic Purchase Management from Unit 2. This is the last topic of Unit 2 and we will then start with Unit 3. Purchase Management is a very important function of every production manager or production department. Purchases of materials have a significant impact on the overall cost and quality of the output. In purchase management, a lot of exhaustive search for vendors, their evaluation, and then the negotiation processes are involved so that the right kind and right quality of material can be purchased for a particular kind of product. Now, what is purchase management all about? Purchase management is concerned with managing, that is planning and controlling, the purchase of goods and other resources to meet the objectives of the enterprise. In other words, a purchase manager has to play an important role of acting a linking pin between the vendors and the organization. Under this function, he is responsible for planning, directing, and controlling the purchases of all kinds related to the production in the plant. Purchase management becomes very important because the material is of very high value and volume. Since the value of the material purchased by the enterprise is too high, so it is very important to undertake this function carefully and with all the cautions and proper evaluation of vendors and kind of material to be purchased. Moving on, we will talk about the importance of purchase management. The first one, purchase management, if implemented properly, can ensure the 5 R's, that is, right quality, right quantity, right time, right price, right vendor related to the materials. Second point, purchase management ensures obtaining necessary materials and parts to facilitate continuous production. That is, a purchase manager makes sure that the necessary and relevant materials that are required for production are made available and obtained well in time so that the production is not hindered. Point number three, if done properly, purchase management can bring down material costs to a great extent. This means, under purchase management function, a purchase manager needs to undertake proper vendor research. There are so many available alternatives in the market. Each alternative vendor is to be understood and evaluated on certain parameters, out of which cost of materials is one significant criteria. On the basis of the cost-benefit analysis, the right kind of vendor is chosen. As a result, the material from him will be of reasonable cost with all discounts and good quality. Point number four, purchase management ensures effective control over material delivery. The purchase manager has to take a follow-up on a constant basis whether the material is received in the factory or not, whether the order placed is delivered from the vendor or not, etc. And the last point, it ensures quality improvement and economy in the total production systems. Naturally, when purchases of materials are tracked properly, managed properly, the overall efficiency and economy is ensured. And the total production takes into account all the wastages and reduces all the unnecessary costs. Next topic is methods of purchasing. Now, there may be several methods out of which the most relevant ones are the first one, purchasing by requirement. This is the method in which goods are purchased as and when required in the plant and in the required quantity. Such goods may not be regularly ordered and may fall under the category of such goods which are also not usually stored because of their irregular need. This means, whenever the plant or whenever the workstations require some goods, some specific kinds of specialized goods, then they can be ordered as per the requirement. Method number two, market purchasing. This refers to buying of material to take the advantage of favorable market situations. Under this, the goods are purchased immediately when their prices in the market are low and the market situations are favorable and beneficial. Point number three, contract purchasing. Under this method, a specific quantity of materials is contracted or promised between the buyer and the seller, along with a negotiated price and other terms of trade. At the time of delivery, the contracted price remains unchanged, irrespective of current prices in the market. Method number four, speculative purchasing. This refers to purchasing at lower prices with an aim to sell them at higher prices in future. The main objective of this method is to earn profits, holding them in present and take advantage of price rise in future. Next point is purchasing. Under this method, several small buyers join hands together to order bulk quantities of material rather than placing their own individual small orders. As a result of bulk purchases, all of them can have good discounts from the seller. Method number six, bundle purchasing. Sometimes a variety of small items are required to be purchased, and in such cases, the buyers can order these. The buyers can order these small number of items as a total package or a bundle in order to enjoy discounts from the vendor. It becomes easy for the vendor to supply an assortment of goods rather than selling individual small items. Last but not the least is purchasing for a specific future period. This method is used for purchase of those goods which will be required at a specific future point to produce a specific kind of product that will be needed in the coming future but not needed in the present. The last topic of this chapter or this topic is purchasing procedure or process. We have seven-stage model that describes the purchasing process in any enterprise. This process may vary from organization to organization depending upon their need and their policies. Stage number one, recognition and description of need. In this stage, a detailed purchase requisition is created that clearly mentions the quantity and quality of material needed to be purchased. Along with this, the date and time at which the material is actually required is also specified. Stage number two, selecting suppliers and requesting quotations. All the possible vendors or suppliers are identified and carefully evaluated so that the best ones can be selected. For this, detailed catalogs, price quotations, variety list and terms of trade are invited from all of them. Stage 3, determining the right prices. Now the purchase department enters into the price negotiation process with different suppliers so as to get the best prices of the materials possible. Stage number 4, issuing a purchase order. After selection and negotiation of prices, the final purchase order with all necessary details about quantity, material specifications, price negotiated, and terms and conditions of trade decided upon are mentioned. The purchase order is duly signed by the purchase manager, and its copies are sent to the department for whom the material is ordered. A purchase department is also responsible for the purchase order to be prepared in details, because this is a documentary proof for all the purchases made by the plant. Stage number 5, follow-up and delivery. The suppliers are contacted to get confirmation from them as to when would they make the final delivery of materials. This follow-up is necessary so as to get the timely delivery of the products or the materials. Stage number 6, accepting and receiving goods. The goods now are actually received at the factory gate and are carefully checked and examined as per the purchase order details. If the goods are found exactly as per the specifications mentioned in the purchase order, they are accepted or else are rejected to be sent back to the supplier. And the last stage in the process of purchasing is approving supplier's invoice and appraising it for final payment. Finally, the suppliers from whom the goods are bought are being paid according to the invoice amounts generated by them after checking the amount and other details mentioned in the invoice. After taking up these seven steps, the purchase procedure comes to an end. With this, we complete our Unit 2 of Production and Operations Management, and we will start with Unit 3, Inventory Control. With this, I sign off. Thank you so much.